On Sky Temple, and this is Team Acer in the blue trunks here on the left side, and they have Zahn playing Stitches, have Baneless playing Uther. In the top lane, we have Greenout playing Tassadar, Polo playing Vala, and in the bot lane, Zagara played by Zypho.
And on the right hand side, in the red trunks, it is going to be Baron 4. And spawning as the Sergeant Hammer in the top lane, it is going to be Karma. Spawning as the Malfurion, it is Zasa Lamel. But we shall call him Zasa. On the Tyrande, we have Kea. Is that how we agreed to pronounce it?
I think Kea? We pronounce it Kea.
Kea. Yeah, Kea sounds about right. It is going to be Aroni, or Aroni, as his name is spelled. Yep, just Aroni. I like Aroni. Aroni is fine. Aroni on the ETC in the mid lane, and in the bot lane, it is going to be Pyrolus, aka Pyro, on the Nazibo.
Oh, this is an interesting interesting lane composition. Nazibo versus Zagara.
Yeah,
both the damage coming out here.
Both the pushes. Right now, it looks like Pyro is focusing more on trying to kill Zypho, but by throwing out those frogs really early, but not able to land anything. Zypho responding in kind with the Hunter Killer. Gonna chase Pyro back into his base.
So they're gonna give a little bit of headway to Zypho with this creep spread, and if he's doing a good job, and so far it looks like he is.
Yeah, well, he has the extra health regen on creep talent as his level 1, so he's gonna be able to get a little bit healing, whereas also Vala running a bit more sustain as well in the top lane. She's actually going on to Karma with the rest of her team. Greenout gets stunned from Kea. Okay, having to back up there. We're seeing a lot of trading back and forth, but Acer coming out ahead in that. But yeah, as I said, siphoning arrow coming out from Vala, giving her a bit more sustain. They're still going very aggressive with the amount of harassment they're doing. Karma dropped very low, having to fountain. In fact, all three members of Baron 4 having to fountain. Aroni currently chilling with Zahn in the mid-tempo.
It's going to be dangerous for Zahn. There's the pushback, and they're going for him, but oh, barely missing that route. Still, that's four heroes here in the mid-tempo. And it looks like they have pretty solid control. Uther turning around. Oh, Acer, they want to go for the steal in this temple here, but Zahn is caught out again and pushed in between all of the Baron 4 members. But Kea, she's dropped so incredibly low and can't get healed back up. It's going to give control of this mid-temple to Acer and will probably force a rotation to Baron 4.
Yep, Baron 4 heading up to the top lane, going to want to try and get at least some of the shots from there. Greenout, though, already up here, is going to attempt to just steal like one or two shots before Baron 4 get there, and he is getting a couple, but now he's going to have to get out of there. He does have Dimensional Shift if he needs to, but it looks like he's going to be able to just walk out of there just fine, even with Sergeant Hammer on his face.
And now it's time for Baron 4 to make their escape. Polo coming from the side there, catches quite a few shots, and Zahn once again caught out, but can they dish out enough damage to take him out before he gets away?
Zahn's gone for an interesting talent choice with the block instead of the healing. That is definitely focused on Tyrande and Sergeant Hammer. Kea having to back out. Aroni gets hooked in. He's already very low. Stun lands on no one, unfortunately, and ETC does go down.
Nice little pick up there, and they're going to get the final shots out of that temple. So pretty much both temples were under solid control here for Team Acer, and that's going to reflect in their siege damage quite heavily. 15,000 also done here by Zagara in the meantime. So, yeah, that's a lot of damage in that bot lane, and almost none for Pyro. He's just really, really preoccupied just dealing with Zagara there.
Yep, this is true. Apparently 5.00 is relevant in this game.
Somehow.
Yep. Not sure what about. Nothing to do with his stacks, but I just had a quick look at his Tundra's Pursuit stacks. But it doesn't look like it has anything to do with that. For now, though, other than the block being taken by Stitches and the siphoning arrow being taken by Vala, very standard builds out of everyone. Vala going for the auto, Vala's actually going for more of a hybrid build, running the battle momentum so that she can get some more abilities out for more damage. The Manticore for that extra auto attack damage, siphoning arrow for that extra bit of sustain. Zagara also running the battle momentum, so this is a hugely push-heavy build she's done. Health regen on the creep going to keep her sustained. The extra damage coming out from her auto attacks on Envenom Spines. And with the battle momentum, she's going to be able to use her abilities very quickly. Hunter Killers going to be popping out every couple seconds.
Yeah, this looks like a really, really strong composition for Team Acer. And it actually reflects. They're about a level ahead here. A little bit more so. And next templates will be coming up here in quite a few. Zahn already waiting down here, waiting for a tiny little mistake here from Pyro, but it's not happening.
Oh, he still very sinks. Nearly. Pyro almost walked in front of the gate there, but Hook just bounced off the gate. He stays alive.
Yeah, they're gonna get to level 10 a little bit faster than their opponents, which should give them a massive, massive leap for those next temples. And I believe they're just gonna spawn down here. And Acer's already in position. They already have three heroes down here. Zahn is about to join them. And Pyro, he needs to retreat out of here. Only one close to that temple.
Yep, having a bit of trouble. Zypho just bullying the crap out of this bottom keep with the rest of his team. Not even using any of his abilities except for, on the very odd occasion, some roaches and that Hunter Killer. The Hunter Killer being his bread and butter in terms of damage here. And with that battle momentum, like we said, is going to be using it very often. And ultimates already ready for Team Acer. Putrid Bile, Archon, Divine Storm, Reign of Vengeance, and the Devouring Maw. Very, very CC heavy.
Wow, Acer is making the best use out of their early level 10 here. They're going for the boss and the temple at the same time. This is really only something you can do if you have that level 10 a good minute ahead of your opponents. And they actually get both of them. All the shots in the temple and that boss.
Yep, that in the meantime insane. Though, we are seeing Baron IV just push very, very heavily onto that top lane. They now have their ults as well, but that's not going to stop Vayner's attempts to slow them down. He's actually just shrugging off any damage that's done to him from these three pushing the fort, and has actually saved the fort. Arony going to use his stage dive, which he did take as his ultimate, to escape the roaming Valor and the roaming Stitches that were trying to gank them there.
Zypho with a little bit of a misclick there on his Devouring Maw. Could have gotten three heroes, but was a little bit too slow. And now we still have those few heroes down here trying to get rid of the boss. And they successfully managed to do so, but there's a strong push coming out of Acer now. Going for the top lane, they already got rid of all of the forts. This is what happens if you lose control of these temples for too long. And now Heat might actually go down there, three levels ahead. This is pretty much insane for Team Acer. There comes Arony trying to jump in there. And he's caught out in the zombie wall. And there comes the Assassin Spirit trying to help him, but it's not going to work. He goes down. Aelis does run away. And Malfurion also picked up here. Hammer with a little bit of a miss, Michael there. But can't stay alive.
Yeah, Apollo also able to vault out, does not get caught. Ravenous Spirit did quite a lot of damage there, was able to get Stitches in the end, but now we are seeing them turn. Pyros getting huge damage from Zypho, and Zypho was on creep, able to just chase after anyone with that stuff step and pick most of them off.
This is perfect play here with this really nice creep threat by Zypho, something you can really only pull off if you do that constantly, and even in these high pressure situations he's doing it.
Yep, Arony clearing up a little bit of the creep there, denying some vision. Like I said, denying that movement speed and the health regen that Zypho has been getting. Very, very effective builds, that the one he is running. Very, very deadly. We're seeing he is still upgrading the Hunter Killers as well. He's taking the Groove Spines for the extra range and damage, so it's huge damage. It's not like the other Zagara that we did see day before yesterday being run by Beatar Bakers, where they were running the Zagara, which was all creep-based.
There comes the hook onto Zazamel, and he's caught out in the Seed Shines. Wow, what a pickup. Team Acer really making the best out of this. Oh, finally a fort going down for Baron IV. And ETC is the only one holding that currently. Everyone else still preoccupied down here trying to stop the Seed Shines that are coming in. And Zahn, oh, he needs to watch out here. Zombie Wall, he's caught out. Heal. Can he stay alive? Trying to spin away. Actually using the Fruited Bile. Is it going to be enough? Karma trying to boost on top of him. And can he get the final blow here? Oh, yeah. With.
Oh, no. Down he goes. Down for the Spirit. Able to finish it off.
Yep.
I think that might have been a bit overkill.
Yeah, I think it might have been.
Yeah, using the Ravenous Spirit on one guy who's running away when Sergeant Amorite was still in auto range might have been a bit too much, but this does allow Baron IV to take full control of this bot temple and get the remaining shots. However, well met in the top lane. Gonna get a keep for this.
Vayner's, they're back in the off right now, but the keep is still gonna fall.
Yep. Hunter Killer and minions able to finish that off. Well met, gonna retreat. Stage dive coming in. Zypho on the run, trying not to get caught out. Nice devouring more. Didn't be able to keep himself safe.
Oh, Arony is going in now. Sapphire comes down, actually hits Karma for quite a bit, but he does get away and is healed back up here by Mathurin. But Vayne is coming in with a great, great CC to round the dust form. And I don't think Zazamot can get out of this either. Oh, that's a triple kill here. And only Sergeant Hammer and Nazgul remain. I think this is gonna be... this might actually be game already. They're level 16. Maybe they're going for the keep instead. But Karma! Oh my god, caught out with a perfect hook here by Zahn. Oh, she should have just boosted the way here.
Indeed. Now I've worked out that your replay is running faster than mine somehow. I have to keep pressing fast forward every couple seconds to catch up. It is weird. I know, so am I. It's weird. It's just how it works, because I think it's just done on PC speed.
Well, they're gonna get that key, and with that, they're gonna back off. We're just at the 10-minute mark, so would have been a little bit too risky to just go for the core. But they're gonna get away here with two keeps down, and that's level 17 versus level 14. Let's have a look at their level 16 talents. It's Pulverize on Stitches, second strike taken by Tassa, who funnily enough took a Distortion Beam as level 13. Then Imposing Presence on Uther, Blood for Blood on Vala, and Root Expansion for more Hunter Killers for Zagara.
Yep, Tassadar is definitely going for a very auto-attack heavy build, giving Acer that extra damage. He took the Static Charge at level 7, giving him the extra crit damage on any enemies marked by his Storm. And the fact he has Second Strike means he's going to be doing a lot of extra crit damage.
We have a question. Why did Vala take Giant Killer if ETC is the only high health hero on the opposing team?
Quite honestly, I do not know. It might just be me because ETC is the one who's getting in the face. It might just be because she already has Manticore and seems to be going for a quite auto-attack heavy thing with Battle Momentum anyway. If you're going quite auto-attack heavy with Battle Momentum with just running Siphoning Arrow for the sustain, then Giant Killer makes a bit more sense, I guess.
Yeah, just auto-attacks all the way through.
Yep, and just auto-everything. Run a Blood for Blood, run a Siphoning Arrow so you have some kind of healing, and then just use the Giant Killer. So Giant Killer is still 1.5% of the hero's max health as extra damage.
Oh,
ETC
stage dive.
Did early.
Once again, but Zahn drops quite low. Starfall actually taking him out. So does Arryn. And Baneless does get away. Yes, I think he can. Renown coming in from the back and doing quite a bit of damage on Kaya. And now Furin also drops incredibly low. Kaya, can she make a getaway happen? Homo is being blocked here by Karma. Really nice move to keep his teammate alive. But on the right side, Uther couldn't give chase. So that's only two heroes going down for both teams. Actually, not a bad fight here for Baron IV, considering that stage dive was not all that useful.
Yeah, if that devouring maw hadn't gone down from the side of Acer, that would have gone a hell of a lot worse for them. Just dropping that was able to lock down the team of Baron IV, who were basically destroying in that fight. And the Baron IV also didn't push into that boss camp when there was no one in it for a good few seconds. They basically allowed Acer to grab it.
They're taking quite a bit of damage from these temples as well, and Core already lost a bit of shield damage here. Yeah, have a look at their level 16 talents. It's Hover Siege Mode for Sergeant Hammer, Specialized Toxin for Nazebo, Imposing Presence for ETC, Shooting Star for Tyrande for a little bit of better Lunar Flare, and then the Tenacious Roots on Malfurion.
Yep, Tenacious Roots. Great ability for locking people down, which may prove as a pretty good advantage. May actually give them a chance of killing Vala, seeing as she's playing very defensively, not chasing anyone, just landing her auto attacks when she can, when her team has the enemy distracted.
And they're turning around. They know, okay, we can't really leave our base now. We have the catapults that we need to deal with, and it's just going to give so much control over to Team Acer to go for these temples as they please. And they have really good map control right now, even going for a split lane here. But Zahn trying to regroup with his allies. There they are. So yep. Maybe they can finally push this through, but they're waiting for a tiny bit of a mistake here from Baron IV, and so far it's not happening.
Yeah, they want Baron IV to push out of their base, so until then, they're just standing here. There's not much else for them to do. Their easy camp is gettable. And so is the enemy easy camp. In fact, they could go and grab that. right now, before those two just came up, there wasn't really anything to do on the map, so they were simply going to not take the risk. Oh, hang on, ETC, stage diving into his team's easy camp, going to try and get something down.
Oh, the Maw! The Maw onto ETC, what a perfect Maw. Starfall not doing all that much, but Zypho needs to stay out of that fight. He's incredibly low, and will have to back off that Kaya dropping.
Oh, Hollow Spot.
And there is the CC out of Uther, taking her out. And Baneless, can he make his getaway happen? I think he can. ETC had to back off here. And they want to go for Zahn, but he's shielded. Good shielding here out of Castle. But is it going to be enough? Nope. I think they can drop him. Nice move. Only one hero down on the side of Baron 4. Can they make this turnaround happen? Greenout trying to get away here. And so is Baneless, but Greenout is going to drop. Just one more shot from Sergeant Hammer, and he's going to fall.
Doesn't have dimensional shift. Down he goes. Arany continuing to chase Vainless and Zypho here. He does now have Pyro with him, but it doesn't look like they'll be able to catch anyone.
Okay, can they capitalize on this? Everyone needs to turn back. They're all pretty low, but...
Well, there's currently three catapults about to be four,
and
two giants on their core. It's actually done a lot of damage.
Health on the core.
Has gone back to base and is going to be dealing with all this, while the rest of the team starts on these temples. Zypho... Sneaky. Looks like he's just going for... Is he just backdooring? He is
all
just
by
backdooring.
Himself. I mean, it's 25%.
He can
health.
Do it. He does have the double Hunter Killer. First Hunter Killer gets instantly wiped out. He gets killed off. Second Hunter Killer dies a bit too quick. But now it's just the minion wave. Minion wave does spawn for the side of Baron 4, though. And that might save the core. Sergeant Hammer staying in base for the defense. But Furion has died somewhere else on the map. There's GGs coming out of everyone. And finally, the temple takes down the core.
I think that's the first kill. Well, I mean, temples killed the core before, but minions doing that much damage on the core? I don't think I've seen that one before. Little bit too late on the turnaround here for Baron 4.
Yeah, Sergeant Hammer did a great job of clearing. Zagara very nearly just ending the game herself, but the distraction she caused, there were two people back in the base for Baron 4, and in that time, Acer were able to roll into a temple, take it over, and get the final shot that ended the game. And only one person actually got their level 20 talent in that fight.
That was a really fast Sky Temple.
It really was.
Okay, let's,
it's a snowbally map. I've been over this.
Yeah, it is. A lot of people complaining about that. You know, I like the map for... Okay, this time I paused exactly when it started. I'm at 0 seconds.
I am just loading up. I just wanted to have a look at some stats. In the last game, so loading up now. I have my finger ready over my P button. Okay, I have also paused at what I think is exactly 0 seconds.
Perfect, let's try to do it.
Alright.
All right. 3, 2, 1, go.
Alright, so we'll find out. If you like mention the time now again, or I'll be able to adjust it just by time. Like, I'm just pushing the plus, the fast forward and the slow down button as I need to as we go. So we should be fine. For now though, ladies and gentlemen, spawning on the left-hand side in the blue trunks, it is Team Acer. And in the mid lane playing the ETC, it is Zon. Playing on the Ufa, it is Vainless. Heading, making his way to the top lane, it is going to be Hollow on the Sergeant Hammer. Zypho bringing out the Kerrigan. And in the bot lane, it is Greenout playing Tassadar.
And their opponents on the right side of the map in the red trunks, they are... Team Baron 4, and we have Aaron playing Diablo, making his triumphant comeback as the Lord of Terror. We have Zazamel playing Rhaegar, and in the bot lane, the triple stack. Pyrolus playing playing the Witch Doctor, Heia playing Tyrande, and Karma playing, well, Bala.
Indeed. Greenout already taking some harassment, going to be able to shield himself to prevent too much damage going down, but nothing too bad to start this game off, and nothing too unusual in the talents either. Diablo going for that more tanky of builds with the extra health and health regen per souls, rather than the quicker respawn, which is actually pretty nice on this map. Like, back in the day, pre-alpha wipe. Oh, hang on. There's a bit of a thing in the bottom lane. Pyro getting pulled in by Kerrigan, and gets taken out.
Yeah, he's popped here. Even though that zombie wall could have saved him, but... just a little bit too late.
Yeah, single auto attack from Green now, able to pick him off from range as he did try to escape. But we're talking about the pre-wipe of the Alpha back in the day. where it was, I think it was first wave actually, it was Ufa and Diablo who would basically, Ufa would die on a tribute and then the tribute fights would go on for ages because it was early game, the first tribute, and Ufa would just respawn and make his way back to the tribute, and the amount of time he'd be there would give his team enough time to just respawn and come get the tribute.
Oh, Zazamal getting a lot of damage onto him. Bayless pushing him out, and Zaun with a really, really good pushback and some solid bloody blocking here out of Bayless. That's two kills going to Acer quite early on. This is going to be quite a bit of an XP lead. That four already available.
I believe this is the actual definition of the Wambulance, where you have the roaming Ufa who heals you when he comes into your lane, CC someone to help you kill them, and you have the Kerrigan to assist with that. Arany having to back out of his lane due to harassment from Hollow, and that's actually good for him because Vainless and Kerrigan get a hit. That's not going to stop him going on him though. Oh, nice tackle to dodge the stun, but still goes down.
It's a third kill, and this is going to give him quite some pushing potential, but it looks like Vainless and Kerrigan, they're going to make their way out of this lane and again go help out ETC in the mid lane. Nice little roaming comp, and this works out quite well. This is not something you see in pub games, but I really like this as a counter to the triple stack, to the party lane.
Yeah, seems to work quite well, because the triple stack, like you said, leaves your other lanes a little bit vulnerable. And it also, a roaming comp, means it's much less suspicious when two people go missing, so it's less likely the Baron 4 will know that Acer are currently stealing their hard cap.
Oh yeah. I mean, this is going to take quite some time. And if it does get noticed, they're in trouble. But so far, Tyrande hasn't seen it, and the Owl is sent towards ETC to stop him from gathering that tribute. And so it looks like they will get those bruisers. And that's level 7, almost there for Team Acer.
Yep, Zaun was actually interrupted taking the tribute by an Owl, but no one came to stop him in the end. He was able to grab that.
So level 7 is up. Oh, interesting build here on Kerrigan. We have Sweeping Grasp, give him a little bit more range on the Primal Grasp, then of course Envenom and Adaption to give her a little bit of a lower cooldown for Ravage.
Yep, Adaptation, pretty nice due to the fact that Kerrigan, her whole point is to jump in and do damage. She doesn't actually have that much escape compared to some of the other melee assassins, for example, Illidan. He can use his dash out, he can use his leap to buildings, he doesn't have and Azeratul has all kinds of blink. Kerrigan, once she has the adaptation, she can jump to friendlies, which is very nice when she needs to have any kind of escape. And the cooldown of Ravage, only 8 seconds, so she does have enough time, and the fact her passive gives her a shield, a little bit of enough tankiness to keep herself alive in time to jump out once she's already gone into a fight.
Yeah, I like this, especially if you're only running a single support. Of course, Tassadar and Uther, they can keep you alive with the shields, with some heals. But Kerrigan, I like this as a way to make their escape happen. And there's the next tribute. It's coming up on Acer's side once again. Oh, disrupt. And they're seeing Vainless in there, in that bush. So far, Baron is not really in a position to stop them. You'd need to gather up here.
It's Zypho giving chase onto Vasa. Vasa does not get stunned, finally gets stunned by Ufa. Zypho taking a lot of damage in the background, gets cleansed, and is now looking to try and go into Karma, already dropped the Envenom onto her. Vainless also able to escape through the back, and no one went for the tribute here, but no one died as well. Zaun might change that though, taking a lot of damage. Shield from Tassadar. Zypho also making his bid for freedom adaptation jumps to Zaun, and that will allow him to escape. Now, that was just a random team fight. The tribute's still up, and we're finally seeing both teams try to get it, and now we will see the usual harassment fights that we see when teams try to get a tribute. Green out, going to be dropping the first harassment on Zasa, so that they can deny it with the storm.
Yeah, but the thing is, Baron 4, they need to back off now. Ooh, there's a stun onto Pyro, and a pushback by Zaun, and the zombie wall completely trapping him. Nice little pickup here, and that's going to be tribute and a free pickup to them. This is going to push this quite hard down here in the bot lane. And the problem was Baron 4, they had to back off just because level 10s once again go into Team Acer. The solid 2-level advantage.
While that was happening as well, Sergeant Hammer, Diablo, had to be back. Sergeant Hammer had harassed him so much, and Sergeant Hammer was able to get that top lane 4. So Acer starting to get a pretty good lead.
Yeah, this is a really solid lead. They're actually going for the towers and 8 down here in bot lane. And Kaya just standing there, waiting for the rest of his team to make a move. And they're not really coming, so this fort is under big distress here as well. They're using this time to go for the boss. Also a nice move. But if they lose support for it, I don't think it was worth it.
Well, luckily for them, Acer is in fact backing out and going for their own boss. Tribute spawns. Acer deciding to abandon the boss and go for the tribute, or at least maybe try and go for the enemy boss. Enemy boss already been taken, though. They're not going to be able to deny that, so it is the tribute that is the order of the day. Ultimates are now available for Team Baron 4. We do have Ravenous Spirit, Raid of Vengeance, Starfall, Ancestral Healing, and the Lightning Breath. Once again, the Owl denying Vainless from taking the tribute.
Yeah, and, but not for this time. Not this time. That's the third tribute going over to Team Acer. Fortunately enough, they will have to deal with that boss in top lane, but looks like they're first gonna go for that push on the fort, get that drop down pretty soon.
Yep, they're gonna take that down pretty quickly.
Having a look at someone's not gonna be there in time to stop it, but instead, they're regathering.
Yep, having a look at Acer's composition at the moment, they're actually running Ultralisk just for that extra damage and Stage Dive rather than the Mosh Pit. And running Stage Dive instead of Mosh Pit is a little bit weird, considering that there's actually not too much CC. There is Stage Dive,
though. Pyro completely out of control, but Nick's successful healing. Can you keep him alive? I think he can, but ooh, he's incredibly low.
And Green Out
the Ultralisk helping out quite a bit, but Green Out drops low. Sypho might be in trouble as well, but nope, they get behind the wall. And Nazibo, in the end, he was taken out.
Yep.
Just a single napalm dropped him down.
Yep, Stage Dive used for escape there at the very start of that fight. Like I said, Zasa trying to chase him to Holo. Holo is going to be able to escape, though. And Ufa very nearly overextending in an effort to save Holo, but doesn't really need to. Going to be able to back out and play it quite safely. With Ufa and Kerrigan running sprint.
On a large distance right there. I mean, just Stage Dive maybe half a screen.
Yeah, just to get over the wall, just to get out of the enemy team.
Yeah, they're gonna go for the bruisers now. But wait and get a little bit more XP to get their level 13 talents, which are gonna be quite vital in that next team fight. But I don't think they're gonna be able to stop Team Acer, which are going for their own boss right now. Instead, should probably just stick around, go for their mercs, and have a little bit something going before the next tribute. They've never managed to pick up a tribute in this game.
Yep, Oracle coming out from Tassadar sees that the enemy team was nowhere near, knew they were safe, to just continue attacking that boss and take it down. So now, Acer gonna start pushing this bot lane with their boss and see if they can pick up any sneaky kills as they do push on. Wow, that double jump is ridiculous.
So great. Let's see, can they push this through? Yeah, level 14, but level 13 not quite available for Baron 4. This is going to give him quite a head start here. And the boss is on top of the key. So far, not really making their move. Now Aaron jumping in there, but he needs to watch out for the root.
Yep, all ultimates are available. So Aaron, he can use his Lightning Breath if he does get engaged upon, which will make him immune to all CC. And there we go, just going to use it a bit in advance. Ravenous Spirit also coming over, but there was no CC or really engagement there. Like, all the damage ultimates, Strafe, Lightning Breath, and Ravenous Spirit. Sorry, not Strafe, just all of the ultimates went down. And there was nothing, because there was no lockdown. Acer just walked away.
Yeah, they're kind of missing the lockdown here. They're going to rely on Reign of Vengeance and just Tyrande locking someone down, and then maybe Diablo for body blocks. And that's exactly the point where they need that Lightning Breath. But this time, Aaron just used it defensively. And I don't know, I mean, didn't really save that keep or gotten the kill, so I don't think it was really worth it.
No, I agree. He may have saved Acer maybe getting a good engage and a kill, but if Acer had got a good engage, it would have very much been Baron 4's fault positioning-wise, because it's very hard to engage someone at that angle unless they're in a bad position.
That's true. Oh, are they going to go for the steal on the bruisers?
They're thinking about the bruiser or the fort, and they can't seem to make a decision of to which.
Yeah, and that's the problem. If you wait for too long, that's not going to happen. Maybe they can surprise someone here. Kamen's coming in, sees they're taking the bruisers. What are they going for? It's only two heroes, but everyone else is joining in the fray now.
They get in
there. Aaron wants to push him out. Can he do it? There comes the Reign of Vengeance. There's the lockdown on Vainless, but he has the shield on top, and CC locking down two heroes. Zazamel's gonna drop. Vainless still in this game. He's being taken out. Aaron just singled out. he's gonna fall here. I don't think there's any way around this. Nope, even the field will go. And he's gonna get control. Two bruisers, blue team Acer, and four heroes.
Acer actually lost the bruisers. Already was able to steal them, he gave his life for it.
Okay.
Yeah, he gave us, like, he was the only one left in it because everyone else focused on the actual the people doing damage. And Arity was just left in there on his own, got the bruises, and then he and the bruises died almost instantly.
This might actually be game already. They're level 17, but the cooldowns are quite low. Everyone's back in that fight. They had still to deal with those bruises. Bought him a little bit of time for Baron 4 to get back up, but the tribute is coming up, and the boss is up. And I'm thinking Acer, they're going to go for that boss.
I would not be surprised if that was the case. Baron 4, though, like you said, they have all had the time to respawn. They're going to be able to regroup, but there's so much they have to deal with. Just having a huge problem. Having a look at their builds, though, we do see Rhaegar has gone for the more healy build rather than the Feral Lunge Rhaegars we've been seeing over the last 2 days. Going with the Healing Surge and the Healing Totem. Diablo going for the tankiest possible build, but having just died, he's going to have to stack all the way back up to 100 souls again before he gets that revive. However, he's looking for his opportunity to maybe try and steal in on the boss, and he doesn't get the circle. Nice knockback from ETC, and there's the lightning breath, but he was facing the wrong way, and now nice split from Acer, making so they don't all take damage, and down goes Valor in the back.
Oh, and Aaron is being singled out again. Starfall comes down, but doesn't do all that much. Stifle drops incredibly low, but they get the kill onto Tyrande. And Valor also first one go down. Pyro is pretty safe back there, but he needs to watch out. Those walls will actually go down so incredibly fast.
Yep, went down very quickly. This boss, gonna be tanky. Pyro, the only one left alive for his team. Valor will be up in 9 seconds. We will see if they can... if Pyro can do anything to defend this. Don't think Acer will go for the kill here.
Well, they still have the boss. They could also rotate down and go for the mid keep. And, well, maybe even go for the bruises at the same time. Still a little bit undecided.
Now the green out is already grabbing that tribute, and that will give Acer the curse.
Curse coming up. Are they going for the bruises? Holo's thinking about it. Zahn joining in the fray.
Yep,
but they need to watch out. Baron 4 don't have to deal with anything right now. And they're gonna go for it. Zahn trying to push him away. Here comes Sentinel onto Holo. He's quite low, but they already have the bruisers, so they can back off and be safe. Aaron running in there, but Zahn, of course, he can just slide away and stay safe. The bruisers are there on the right side. So Acer is using that to go in once again. And Aaron going for the Lightning Breath. Successful healing coming in. He stays alive, but Lightning Breath not gonna be enough to go down on Holo, and he falls once again. Those souls not really stacking up for him, and two heroes down. I think they will actually go for the kill right here now.
Zypho, I think Zypho just killed himself. He decided to charge in and use his Ravage with no mana.
Oh well, best idea, but still four heroes versus three, and a 3 level advantage, almost level 20 here for Team Acer. But I don't think it's gonna matter. Shields are down, and a core is gonna fall. It's 2-0 for Team Acer.
Yep, very well played by them. So,